everybody for coming out. Let's get a round of applause for everybody that came out. Secondly, I would like to just thank everybody for being here. Thank you to Mrs. Alvarado for taking all of us. She doesn't have a son, by the way, babe. She doesn't have a son.
Wow, I'm pretty sure.
So, we love you, Chris, and you can turn all this up. And thirdly, I'd like to thank the volleyball team, the children team, let's give it up for them. I would like to thank Mr. Frank Pappas right here. He's doing video for the whole event.
Yeah.
And also, my mom, photographers, Lamaran, Baby, Jared, Mr. Lamaro. And thirdly, I would like to thank all my seniors. Jack, you have Jack right here, let's give it up for him.
Darling,
Take my whole life to for I can't help falling in love with you, for I can't help falling in love with you. Thanks, babe. I'll have this special video that I prepared for you. I hope that you enjoy it.
Happy 6-year anniversary, Michaela Wright Proctor. It all started 6 years ago today when I officially made you mine. After dating for a while, you told me that you wanted to be high school sweethearts. Now at that time, I was only a senior in high school and you were only a junior. We were always the flyest couple everywhere that we went. But on an important note, we graduated from high school together, and throughout that process, we pushed each other to become the best people that we could be. People say that they don't believe in young love, but you and I say that we disagree. We pushed each other to receive our associate's degrees together. You pushed me to excel and mature and to grow. Aside from my family, you have always been my number one fan. Like, we literally grew up together. Like, we watched each other grow from teenagers to young adults. We were together when I didn't have any chin hair and no mustache. I still remember when you got your braces off. You were so excited. I literally watched you grow from a young lady into a young woman. And you helped me grow from a young boy into a young man. But most importantly, you taught me that a king always needs a queen. And when times got rocky in our relationship, you stood right by my side. And I truly love you for that. When you invited me into your family, they accepted me. And when I told you about my dream to start Chosen Training, you poured into my dream. And when I was about to drown at that lake, you swam over there and you tried to rescue me. So Michaela, honestly, you belong next to me for eternity. Thank you so much, Mrs. Wright, for raising a wonderful daughter. And thank you, Mr. Proctor, and thank both of you for blessing me with this.
I was talking about what y'all gonna do for the D, but I'm gonna let y'all know what I'm gonna do for my husband.
Husband!
The grown sexy.
Let him know, little Kayla.
I'm gonna cook and clean for my husband.
Pint tall.
Even wear tight jeans for my husband.
No skirt.
I'm gonna be a fiend for my husband.
Ooh.
Even have a couple sons with my husband.
Children.
They gonna play one-on-one with my husband.
Jordan.
Basketball, Chosen Training. That's my husband.
Hey.
I'm gonna read my Bible with my husband.
Devotion.
Even when we fuss and fight, that's my husband.
Husband.
I'm gonna make love to my husband.
Trey Songz.
Side dudes, not for me, just my husband.
Take it.
I'm gonna buy a home with my husband.
Real estate.
Even book a flight to Rome with my husband.
First class.
I'm gonna spend some years with my husband. Hey.
Who are you?
only 2 more days into the big event. Man, it's truly going amazing. I was able to get 2 amazing singers. It's gonna be great. It's all for you, babe. Love you.
I just want to take this time out to thank God for being such a great creator. Look at this girl, Michaela, my baby.
What? Cute. You're so
my baby cute.
Now tell the real truth. Tell the people how you feel about yourself.
I think that in this relationship, you're the best looking one.
Oh my gosh.
If you were a tear in my eye, I would never cry. I guess what I'm trying to say is that you make me want to jump off the highest building in the city to prove that I don't miss school when you're standing next to me. In fact, I'm convinced that Cupid ran out of arrows the day that I met you. He must have had the height of the plane and went right into my heart. When I first saw you at that bus stop, my first look to you, it was as if you had a cloud of beauty surrounded around you, like the aqua beauty that devoured the birds in the sky. When I think about you, I think about your eyebrows and how when you blink, they play simple. No, but seriously, when you agreed to date me, I said that this girl is crazy. But I guess you have to be crazy to fall in love. You have to be willing to give the most intimate pieces of yourself and trust it with hands that crack and shape like a Haitian side. But it is a prerequisite if you want to turn two halves into a whole. This was my first step toward becoming a man. Michaela, beyond your physical appearance, you have displayed willing patience and willingness to fight for us no matter the circumstances. In these past 6 years, you have taught me four very important lessons. One, you taught me that life would never make sense until I made a change. And along this journey of change, we both grew up and matured physically, mentally, but most importantly, spiritually. You taught me that true love sticks around to endure the tough stuff. I still remember like it was yesterday. I told you that I was going to the movies and ended up going to your best friend's 16, where 13 people got shot. Although I didn't feel that bullet pierce my skin, I remembered one thing, that as soon as that the smoke cleared, you were so crazy. You taught me that if a boy breaks something, like a woman's heart, he becomes a man if he's willing to stick around and put the pieces back together. This was my second step toward becoming. You have taught me that true love sacrifices. Just as Jesus Christ gave his life for humanity, I must set myself apart from you and only you. So throwing this event is one of the many major steps towards manhood. But before planning this event, I had to ask myself how much I loved you. Because my mind was filled with numbers, I thought it would be wise to answer this my own question with math, right? So, Michaela, I've been loving you for 72 months. That breaks down to 313 weeks, which is equivalent to 2,093 days, which is synonymous to 52,632 hours, 3,157,920 minutes, and 189,475,200 seconds. I have thought about